In the last class, we were seeing the binary addition. We have seen binary addition and then binary subtraction. So just before proceeding to the next one, I just brush up your mind. That is, in order to do a binary subtraction, what you have to do is you have to find the either a 1's complement of the subtrahend or 2's complement of the subtrahend. This is what we have seen in the last class. So when you do 0 minus 0, you will get 0. 0 minus 1, since this is smaller number and bigger number, like ordinary decimal number, what we will be doing, when you subtract a bigger number from a smaller number, you will be having a negative number. Okay. So same way here, 0 minus 1 means you have to borrow. Not only that, you will borrow one value from the previous digit. Same way, you have to borrow one digit from this, so make it as 1 0 and then subtract 1. So in which case what we have is the answer is 1 and then a borrow is 1. Okay, then 1 minus 0, since this is bigger number and this is smaller number, 1 minus 0 is 1. 1 minus 1 you have 0, because both the numbers are same. So this is the basic rule of binary subtraction. So in order to do a binary subtraction, you have to find either the 1's complement or the 2's complement. So how will you find the 1's complement? The values present in a particular binary digit has to, you have to find the just its opposite. Say for example here, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0 means you have to find its reverse, that is inverse. So 0 means 1, substitute this with 1, 1 means 0, 0 means 1, like that. So for all the digits, you have to find its opposite, that is inverse number. So that we call it as inverse also, and we say that as a 1's complement. Then after finding that value, you have to add it with this value. So for example, this is called minuend and this is called subtrahend. So what you have to do is, for this subtrahend, you have to find the 1's complement. So find 1 1 0 0 1 1 1 1, and then add with this. So there is no actual subtraction. Okay, if you take in digital, there is no subtraction, there is no multiplication, and there is no division. Everything is addition only. Even if you take multiplication in normal decimal number calculation also, when you are doing a multiplication, say for example 7 into 5, you have multiplication table, you know multiplication table, so you would say 7 into 5, what? 35, isn't it? But actually, what you can do is 7 plus 7 plus 7 plus 7 plus 7. That is 5 times you add 7 are 7 times you add 5. That also you are doing only addition. So a multiplication, you can say it as addition. And a division, repeated subtraction. Okay. But since here that subtraction is also not there, we are going to do only with by finding 1's complement and add with the minuend, you will get the value. Okay. So in everything here, it is only addition. So if you know addition properly, it will be there will be no problem. Okay, so what we have to do is, the rules for subtraction is, first find the 1's complement of the subtraction and then add this with the minuend. Then if the result of addition has a carry, which means if there is a carry out from the last digit, then we can consider that as a positive number. Okay, and then you have to bring down that carry to the least significant bit and then add it. When you add it, you will get the final answer. Whereas if you don't have any carry, then you can consider that answer to be a negative number, and then you have to find the complement of that answer again. That will give you the final result. Now we'll see this. So all these things I have taken in the last class itself. Just to brush up your mind, I'm taking it again. So let us consider these two numbers. This is minuend and you call it as a subtrahend. Okay. So minuend, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 digits are there. But normally you have to make it as a 8 bit. So what you do is, with this, you add two more zeros to the leftmost. You should not add in the rightmost. If you add rightmost, the value will change, yes or no. So you have to add it in the leftmost, which does not have any value for that. So we make it as a 8 bit by adding zeros. So for example, if you have only 5 digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have to add 3 zeros. Okay, that's all. Then for this also, what you do is 101001, then add two more zeros. Now, after that, you find the complement, one's complement of the number. So now you, what you are getting, one is 00110 and then 11 and then this is 0. Since we have added two more 0 here, when you find complement, it becomes 11. Okay, now this is the one's complement of this subtrahend. Now add these two, you will get this value and there is a carry coming out of this. So this carry, what is the rule? When this is a positive number, when there is a carry, you can understand this is a positive number. And then this, the carry, you have to bring down the carry to the least significant bit and then add it. Then again, you will be getting a value. So this is our final answer. You can check your answer by substituting its respective, by finding its respective decimal number. So if you take this, see here, the decimal number has been calculated for this. I have given only the values for the one which has one, because when you multiply it by zero, it becomes zero. So I didn't put this here. So one is 1 into 2 power 0. This is 1 into 2 power 2. 2 power 1 is 0 here. So then 2 power 3 is also 0 here. So I have left all those terms. So when you multiply all these things and add all these things, you get 53. Same way you find it for that, you have 37. When you subtract, you have 16. And the decimal equivalent of this number is also 16. You can verify because it is 2 power 4. Okay. Now, we'll take a negative number. This is for positive number. This is another example for a negative number. So, this is a bigger number and this is a smaller number. You please find the equivalent value of this. So when you do 101011, you have this value 43. For this, you have 57, which is a bigger number. So when you subtract, you get minus 14. Now we'll see how we can handle it in the binary subtraction. Now you write as such by substituting extra zeros here. So this is the value. Then here you put 00 and then find one's complement. When you see this, see here 011000, then two zeros, it have, you have complement. Now you add this, see there is no carry, which means this is a negative number. You can say negative 14. Here it is nothing but negative 14. Now you have to find the ones complement of this answer again. So find the ones complement, you have this value. Now you can see this equal. See, to know why, you can say that we can leave it as such. Yes, we can leave, but we don't know whether it is a, what number it is. So that is why without carry, it represents a negative number. In order to know the true value, you find its ones complement and then find its respective decimal number. You can compare your result. For that only, we are doing it again. Now, we will see today the binary subtraction with fractional part. So here we have this value. This is one value, mind you, and this is another value subtraction. Now, as usual, you add extra zeros here. For this, there is no need, whatever it is. But you have to equalize after decimal places. Here we have 3 decimal places. Here we have 2 decimal places. So what you do is, you add 0 after this in order to equalize the decimal places. Then only we can do the subtraction. Okay, so here, first you take this value. Here only 4 values are there. So remaining 4, you add 4 extra zeros. So in order to make it as an 8 bit. And 001. Okay, now for this, here only 3 values are there, so you have to add 5 zeros. So when you add 5 zeros and complement, now you have 5 ones. Then this is 00 and this is 1 dot. Here we have, as I said, you add one more 0 and then find its complement 110. So adding of 0 has to be done before doing any, before finding any ones complement or before finding any addition, etc. Okay. So now subtract, for this is the equivalent value of this. Now add this. When you add 110, then here you have 1 carry. And then when 1100, then here 1 carry. So 1 plus 0 plus 0, you have 1. Dot 110, you have 1 carry here. So 1 plus 1, here 0. And then here 1 carry. So 1 plus 0 plus 0, you have 1. Now again here, we have 1 plus 1. It is 0, 1, 1 plus 1, 0, 1, and so on. So here, finally, we have, we will be having 1 here. 1 plus 1, 0, and there will be a carry. Now, what you have to do in previous subtraction, what we have said, in when you find a 1's complement and you have a carry out, then it is a positive number, and you bring down the carry to the least significant bit and add. Here, the least significant bit is not here. It is in the fractional part. So, bring down that and here add. Now, 1, 0, 1 dot, etc. Now, how you find the equivalent. See here how we have found. For this, it is 2 power 0, 1, here 2 is not there, so 2 power 3. Plus, here 2 power minus 1, 2 power minus 2, and 2 power minus 3. 2 power minus 3 is 1 by 8. Okay. So, now add all these things, you will get 11.125. Already, I have given you the value of what is 1 power 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 8. If not, you find it. Okay. So, you can calculate it 1 by 8. You will be getting 0.125. So, this is the answer of this value. And then for this, we find the equivalent. So, here it is 2 power 1. Okay. Here we have entered 2 power 0 it is. Okay. 2 power 0 is... This into 2 power 0, that is 1. So, here we will be having 1. And 2 power 1, 2, not that. And then 2 power 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Actually, what we have done is, we have to calculate for this. Okay, not for this. In the previous example also, not for 1's complement, you have to find the equivalent. You have to find the equivalent of the original value. So, that is what here also we have done. So, when you say 2 power 0 is not there, so 2 power 1 here, 2 power 2. So, for this value only, you have to find, not for the 1's complement. If you find it for 1's complement, it will be a wrong answer. So, you have to take the original value, and for that you find first the decimal value. Then you can keep on going, do this subtraction, etc. Okay, so if you do that, here it is 2 power 1 by 2. So, 1 by 2, then if you find equivalent, 2 power 2, 4 plus 2, 6. This is 6.5. Now, add these two. You have to find the subtraction. So, when you find subtraction, what you will be getting? You do the decimal subtraction. This is 5 and then 2 is as it is, and here 1. So, you get, you borrow one thing. So, it becomes 11. 11 minus 5, it is 6 point. Then here it will be 0. Make it as 10. So, 4.625. This will be the answer. Now, we will see whether we are getting that answer. Now, here we have found the answer. We have found the binary equivalent. Now, you substitute its decimal equivalent. So, what you do is here, this. Now, this is 1 by 2, this is 1 by 2. 1 by 4, 1 by 8. Okay. Then here it is 0, 1, 2. 2 power 2. So when you find its equivalent, what will be you getting? This is 4 plus 0.5 plus 1, 1. That is this 1.25. You will be getting this answer. So now take down this problem, all of you. This is for binary subtraction with fraction. Note down this program, note down this problem, and I have given the answer also. And this is for a bigger number. This is a smaller number, and this is a bigger number. So, you are getting a negative value. You please check the same way. Already I told you how to find, how to do binary subtraction for negative numbers. Okay, so do it as such. You take this as an assignment problem. Now, Already I told you, you can do a subtraction with 1's complement and 2's complement. Just now we have seen using subtraction using 1's complement. Now we'll go for subtraction using 2's complement. So the rules, 2's complement of the subtrahend must be found. Add it with minute. If the final carry over of the sum is 1, it should be dropped. In the 1's complement, you have brought down, bring down the carry and add. But here in 2's complement, you have to drop it. Okay. Whereas if there is no carry, the result is negative. So find the 2's complement of the result again. Okay. Now we'll see how to do it using 2's complement. Now if you see this, see here. Again, we are substituting extra 20 because this is only 6 digits. And this is another, this is minor and this is subtrahend. So here we have found the, after substituting 00, we have found the first 1's complement. So how will you find the 2's complement? Find the 1's complement and then add 1 with it, you will be getting the 2's complement. Simple. Okay. So here what we are doing is we are adding 2 zeros and then we are finding the 1's complement. So with this 1's complement, you add 1. See here, 1, 1. Now this is said to be the 2's complement. Now this and this must be added and you will get this value. See here, you have to consider this and this. 1 plus 1, 0. 1 plus here, carry you will be having 1 plus 1, it is 0. Then again you will be having carry 1. 1 plus 1 here, here 0. And then 1. Here you will be getting this when you yes carry, you have this value. Now 1 minute. We'll write down this in a separate, okay, so that will be more clear to you. 1 minute. Now, this is the 2's complement value. Now, we are going to add these two. Be able to follow? This is the minute. For the subtrahend, we have how you have to find the 2's complement. How it can be found? First, you have to find the 1's complement and add 1 at the least significant bit. You will be getting a value that you call it as a 2's complement. Simple. Now you have to add this and this. Okay. We'll see how to add. So when you do addition, what you will be getting here, 1 plus 1, it is 0. And then 1 carry. So 1 plus 1, it is again 0. Then you get 1 carry. So here 1 will be carry. 1 1 0 1 carry, 1 1 0 1 carry, then again here 1 carry, so you'll be getting 0. Okay, again there is a carry, so this up to 3 digit is over. Here 1 carry, this digit produces a carry, so here you bring down this, bring here the carry here. 1 plus 1 you have again a 0. Then again here carry is that. So 3 ones are there. 1 plus 1, 0, 1, 0. Again with that when you add 1, it gives 1, 1. So now you write 1, 1 and this 1 is carry here. Okay. So 1 plus 1. Again 1 plus 1 you have 1, 0. Okay. So and 1 carry. Now the positions are over. So 1 plus 1, 0. Here 1. Again it is 1 plus 1, 0. Okay. Again carry 1. 1 plus 1, it is 0. then we have 1 as a carry. Okay, now so this is a carry. After this, I hope you are able to follow. Are you able to follow, girls?
Yes, ma'am.
This is the answer which you are getting here. That is what I have posted here. Okay, 0001, then 40. See here, and 1 carry. Now, so this is the now what you have to do is, a carry is produced in 2's complement. When a carry is produced in 2's complement, you can consider this as a positive number. Okay, and you leave down the carry. Whereas in 1's complement, what you did, this carry, you bring down the carry and add it, and you will be getting the answer. But here, what you have to do is, you have to just drop the carry. You should not take this carry as an answer. You have to find the decimal equivalent of only this after dropping this carry. So you will get the answer. So this is your answer. When you 53 minus 37 will give you 60. So this is the decimal equivalent of this. Are you able to follow? Any doubt so far?
No, ma'am.
Shall I proceed to the next one?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
So in 1's complement, when there is a carry, you have to bring down the carry and add, and you will be getting the result. Whereas when you find the 2's complement and when there is a carry, you know very well that it is a positive number. It is a positive number both in 1's complement and 2's complement. The difference is, in 1's complement, when you find 1's complement, you will have to bring down the carry, add it. Here you should drop the carry. Okay, that is the difference. Okay, now we'll see for negative number. Here, same way. This is minute and this is upper hand. For this upper hand, you find 1's complement and then 2's complement. By adding 1, you will be getting the 2's complement. So this is the answer. Okay. 1 minute.